Testing, testing, testing.
Out front, I'm Andrew, alongside with
Kel.
It's your birthday, Kel. Huh? It's your birthday, Kel. We're gonna play on this attitude, we're just gonna go with this. This is the atmosphere, this is the first episode
of Up Front.
We're just gonna break the ice this time, so we're just gonna mellow it, chill it out this time, give you a bit of a personality for the camera here, and pretty much see how this thing goes.
Exactly. That's the way we're going to play it now.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Yes. I'm going to be the straight lace.
The straight lace. I don't know why that's funny. Probably because I'm standing in front of the camera. Potential viewers watching.
Yes. We're going to hear you in the microphone.
Oh, I hope that thing's on. It says it's on. Look at that.
Hey,
we've got a bit of a budget going here. Like, we actually got our names.
And East there, Troy. Both teams, they're sort of my dark horses for premiership honours this year. I know we've got Wynnum, Manly and Redcliffe at the top of the table, but I'm certainly not riding off East or Ipswich or Northern Pride, mind you, who are currently sitting in seventh position. I think they're too good a side to be where they are on the table at the moment. Well, the siren you can hear, that's the warning to the players to come onto the field. They're just clearing the dancing girls off the field as we speak. The preliminaries are done. They're shared one all, and this is bound to be an absolute cracker of a match. I don't know if we'll see the open, free-flowing style of football that we saw at Cougar Eye Oval, but I think the intensity and the passion will certainly be there, Troy. It's always good between the East Tigers and Winnemana.
Oh, there is the, as they say,
the local derby.
The local derby and that overused terminology of tribalism in the modern game. And, again, it's just a construct of the media fraternity, but there is genuine feeling between these clubs because of the proximity and the movement of players. I mean, I came from Wynnum to East because at that stage I thought the club was in a better position to give me the the potential to become a first grader. Unfortunately, that didn't happen, but I certainly enjoyed my time at both clubs, and there was always feeling when you came up against your old teammates and also the moniker that was formerly on your jersey, and it just transfers to another club, but you embrace the culture where you are, so... Well, it's always going to exist in the Queensland Cup between these two clubs.
Wynnum Manly first team onto Langlands Park this afternoon. That was the cheering you could hear. And it would appear that Wynnum Manly will be kicking off, and therefore East will get first use of the ball this afternoon. In fact, they are. They're lining up across halfway as we speak. Wynnum Manly will be running from the scoreboard end of Langlands Park. That's the northern end here at Stones Corner. East receiving first use of the ball. They'll be running from the clubhouse end. That's for those that are familiar with the ground. And Wynnum Manly, as I mentioned earlier, the only one change there with Junior Tongia out of the side as Peter Gubb was ruled fit, and he will take his place on the wing.
Just to preface to you, Cormac, I just wanted to also thank the contribution of Russell Maher when I was unable to make the journey to the Central Capras Wynnum Manly game. I thought Russell brought a lot of panache and personality and charisma to the call, and I just want to thank him for his efforts in my absence. So thank you, Russell.
Well, East just coming out onto the field as we speak. McKenna Gibson firing up his troops down here on the try line. We are down near the clubhouse try line this afternoon, so we may just bear with us if we lose identification with some of the players when they get up to the scoreboard end here at Langlands Park, because it is some 100 metres away. Wynnum Manly have the ball set. Matt Seamark standing there waiting for the referee to blow time on. He's checking with both captains, and there goes the whistle, and Matt Seamark brings this very important match underway. It's a high midfield kick that only goes about 35 metres. It's taken there well by Corey Thompson, and he takes the tackle about 12 metres out from his own line. Played back to Gibson. He gets it straight away there to Big Mitch Garbutt. Garbutt takes it up to 22 out from his own line. Mark of defence was good there from Tim Natush right in centre field. And starting on the field there, I noticed Troy Stephen Thorpe wearing number 19, and we'll just pick who has started off the field. It may actually be Wiramu Ratana. We'll just check across the field there as Ken Bromwich bounces off one tackle before he's turned around there. Good tackle there by Charlie Gubb. Rides him into the ground. 32 out from their own line. The Tigers played back to McKenna Gibson. He almost splits them there. Great tackle there by Jake Granville, lucky to get away without being penalised. Comes back there to Cody Walker. There's the first kick of the afternoon down towards the Canbar corner. Good crowd here at Langlands Park this afternoon. It's picked off there by the fullback Sean Loxley. Runs it back towards centre field, and he'll be stopped on his own 10-metre line, almost in line with the left upright. Played back there to Barnes. Barnes gets it away to Peter Gubb. Peter Gubb drives with the legs, goes straight and hard, brings it up to about 18 metres out from his own line, right in centre field. Played back to Granville. Looks right, goes left, finds hard running down. Dane Carlaw almost gets out of the first tackle there of Thorpe, but eventually they chop his legs out and pull him down. Charlie Gubb for his first touch this afternoon. He'll take about 10 metres, thank you very much, straight up the middle of the field. He'll be wrapped up by Thorpe and ridden into the ground. Granville gets a good ball away there to Luke Dalziel-Don. Steps off the right there. Dalziel-Don doesn't get away from the defence, but they're just up on halfway now, Wynnum Manly. So he's their first kick of the afternoon. Seamark has it. He goes straight down the middle of the field, but dropping back to take it very well there is Ryan Tongia. He accelerates straight and hard, drops the shoulder in, and brings it out of the danger zone there for the Tigers. Makes it to 23 metres out from his own line. Just on the grandstand side of the uprights now. Played back to Shay Moylan. Moylan pushes off the first one, but Moon slows him down long enough there, and coming in to make the tackle there over the top there was Matt Seamark. Played back to McKenna Gibson. A mistimed pass. Goes there to Corey Thompson. Back towards centre field, and he'll be stopped about 8 metres his own side of halfway. Played back to Gibson. He comes left there. It's with Ken Bromwich. Good yards there by Bromwich. Takes it up into Wynnum Manly territory, straight up the middle of the field. He'll get up and play it back to McKenna Gibson. They put it through the hands. Kaufman finds hard-running Mitch Garbutt, turns around in the tackle. Not going to get the ball away there. Four Wynnum Manly players in there to make the tackle. He'll be stopped about 8 metres inside Wynnum Manly territory. Played back to Gibson. It comes across field. Cody Walker's kick again. Going down towards that Canbar corner, but Loxley's down there, reads it well, gets it on his own try line, does well. He was surrounded there by a good chase there from the Tigers, but he manages to bring it out into the field of play, and Wynnum Manly will ruck it back upfield. Nat Barnes takes the second one.
Yes, a competent, methodical start from both sides, Mike. Getting to the end of their sets, I've been impressed also with the hulking figure of Michael Garbutt for the East Tigers, and he's certainly committing quite a few defenders in the initial exchanges at the start of each set. So good position for both sides to be in at this point in the match.
East skipper Shane Newman, very prominent in defence at the moment. He's probably one of the leading tacklers on this field as Wynnum Manley put it through the hands. Dalziel Don out of the first one, takes about another 8 metres, doesn't quite get up to halfway. Here's the last play for the Seagulls. It comes across field. Fayou gets his first kick of the afternoon, goes down the centre of the field, goes straight down the throat of Tongia, gets a good ball away there to Thompson. Thompson runs it back, can't get away from the defence. The chase was good there, and John Grieve was the first one to reach him and slow him down. Wynnum Manley wrap him up. They're 11 inside their own half, the Tigers. Played it back. Cody Walker finds Shane Moylan driving hard with the legs. Moylan takes about 10 metres, takes some stopping. He'll play it right on halfway. Played it back now. It's with Ryan Tongia. Goes across field, dummy steps and has to eventually take the tackle. Buchanan Gibson into dummy half. They go right again. He's looking to link up. He didn't have the big forward runners that he was hoping for there, and it ends up in the hands. I think that's Eddie Tautali who ended up taking that tackle. Anyway, it's with McKenna Gibbs, and they put it through the hands. Oh, it's a high tackle there, and it's Shane Newman comes up with the penalty. It was Peter Gubb, who's just a little bit lazy there, the swinging arm. There wasn't any malice in it, but certainly it was above the shoulders and worthy of a penalty. So this will put the Tigers in good attacking position. They will start this attacking set only about 28 metres out from the line. Now comes a crossfield there. Zgrajewski takes the first one up, drives hard. He makes it up to within 10 metres of the Wynnum Manly line. He'll play it back to Gibson. They'll come left towards centre field again. It's with Thorpe. Thorpe just didn't quite get the run onto that pass. Had to take it semi-flat footed, but he'll take it up to about 5 metres out from the line. Played back to Gibson. Gibson goes right. It's with Kaufman. There's a good ball out there to Thompson. Thompson finds a flying winger. I think East have gone in, and it might be Eddie Tautali who's gone in. It's a diving effort there. Magnificent quick hands there close to the Wynnum Manly line. The try's been awarded. We've had 5 minutes of play here at Langlands Park, and East leading 4-0.
Yes, Mike, wonderfully constructed by the East Tigers. They have come with a great formula for success this afternoon, because they're using both their golden mean in relation to the way that they're constructing their attack around the fringes of the ruck, because McKenna Gibson is finding the big runners such as Mitchell Garbutt and also Steve Thorter, a masterstroke by coach Troy McCarthy to start with the big fellow, and he's absorbing quite a few defenders, multiple tackles being made to try and hold his progress. And then it's going out to, as you mentioned, Cody Walker, and then a wonderfully crisp, beautifully fluid pass from Isaac Kaufman picked up the outside backs, and it was just a draw situation where the winger was committed to come in, created the overlap, and they crashed over for a very well constructed try in the early exchanges of this match, Mike. And so, look, I'm impressed with the way the Tigers have started, and Troy McCarthy also just a masterstroke, as I mentioned, to just reorganise and shuffle his starting forward pack with the bigger men to certainly compete with Charlie Gubb, Dane Carlaw, and the big imposing forward pack from the Wynnum Manly Seagulls. So a great start to the East Tigers, Mike.
Well, the conversion successful there. It was about a metre in from touch and about 25-odd metres out from the line. It was a terrific kick there by Cody Walker, and he lands his first goal for this afternoon. So the Tigers up 6-0. We've had 7 minutes of play. Seamark hoists it long down towards the dressing room corner here at Langlands. Taken there by Gibson. Gets a good ball away there to Thorpe. Thorpe goes straight and hard. Brings it up to 21 out from his own line. Midway between the post and the grandstand side of Langlands Park. Goes across field now. That's with big Mitch Garbutt. Drives hard. Geez, a big unit to stop there, Troy. And he certainly hits the ball at pace. Played back to McKenna Gibson. They put it through the hands. It comes across field. Now it's with big Zgrajewski. Zgrajewski trying to get, offloads out the back. In the end, the tackle will be made there by, just trying to pick who that is. I think it's Dan Wallace that might have ended up making that tackle. But East still in possession, just shy of halfway. And Wynnum Manley looking to dig deep because East are on the boil again. Played back to McKenna Gibson. He'll kick from dummy half. Go down towards the scoreboard corner here at Langlands Park. Loxley ducking back, hoping it'll drop dead. It's a magnificent kick. It pulls up short. Loxley gets back out into the field to play. Brilliant football from both McKenna Gibson and Loxley there. Played back to Nat Barnes. He gets it away there to looks like that's in the hands there of Dan Wallace, and he'll be stopped 10 out from his own line. Played back to Nat Barnes. Barnes comes back towards centre field, takes about 7 or 8 metres, but four East defenders to slow him down, and three of them will wrestle him into the ground. 21 out from their own line, the Seagulls. Played back to Granville. They come right towards centre field. Fayoud, Seamark. Now it's out there with Grieve. Grieve, oh, grabbed awkwardly, spun around, a tackle's made there, trying to get up for a quick play of the ball. Now he finally gets it played away. Played back to Moon. Moon steps. I think he was caught out there, Moon, but he'll take about 20 metres straight down the grandstand sideline here at Langlands Park. Played it back now. Goes back across field. It's with Seamark. Steps back inside. He puts a low kick in down towards the change room corner again. It's picked up there by Thompson. Thompson runs it back into the field of play, and it was almost a flop there from Seamark. Fayoud had already made the tackle. Now it's with Shane Moylan, straight and hard. Holds off Fayoud with his left hand, but Grieve comes in to finish him off with the help there of Granville. East about 15 metres their own side of halfway. Played back to Mechanic Gibson. Gets a good ball away there to Kenny Bromwich, but he's going nowhere, and the Wynnum Manly defence up to the task. Played back to Mechanic Gibson. Finds hard running... I think that's Zgrajewski again. Takes that next one up, and he takes it up inside Wynnum Manly territory. Now it's out there through Walker. Walker gets a good ball away there to Garbutt. Garbutt tries to hold off the defence. Can't do so. He'll be wrestled into the ground. 28 out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Kaufman. Kaufman kicks from dummy half, going down towards that corner. It's picked off there by Loxley. Loxley runs it back infield. Still gets away. Just gets ankle tapped there. It was a lucky thing, because he was into a bit of open space there if he had have gotten through. Now it's in the hands of the Seagulls. They're only 20 metres out from their own line, two tackles down. Played back to Granville. They come back towards centre field. Straight up field there goes Peter Gubb. Takes the tackle, gets up, plays it back to Granville. Granville gets it away to big Charlie Gubb now. Steps off the right, showing a little bit of hop, skip and dance there, Troy. Maybe it's that bit of that Kiwi touch football coming out in him. Played back to Seamark. There's a kick, not a particularly good one. Straight down the throat there of Thompson along the ground, and he methodically steps around three Wynnum Manly defenders. A tackle's eventually made, but East are now still only 15 metres their own side of halfway, and certainly looking a little more dangerous with the ball in these early stages, Troy.
Yes, Mike, I've been extremely impressed with the application of both sides, especially around the rucks. McKenna Gibson is certainly marshalling his big forwards, as we see a handling error which will lead to the first
error of this match. Yeah, that was Ratana who's put that
down. Who received an ill-timed and ill-conceived pass from Cody Walker there, which has led to...
There was no real reason to throw it there. No. It was early in the count. They're already up nearing halfway. So Wynnum Manly will come up with the loose head and feed right on the halfway, and about midway between the uprights and the Villanova side of Langlands Park.
We are seeing, Mike, both sides willing to spread the ball from the early sets.
They're backing themselves, Troy.
They are, yeah. They're really trying to exploit their potential to score on the fringes.
Scrum, one there by Wynnum Manly, and it's a good run there by Dan Wallace. He'll get up and play it back to Granville. They put it through the hands now. Seamark out there to Moon. Moon tries to get away from Moylan, can't do so. Slowed him down long enough, and Tongia comes in to finish off the tackle. Played it back there to Gubb. He goes across to Seamark, to big Dane Carlaw, driving with the legs straight up the middle of the field. He brings it up to about 27 metres out from the east line. Played back to Granville. They go back across field through Seamark. To Fayoud, sending it wide, a mistimed pass. It just caught, I think that was Dan Wallace, just caught him off guard there, Troy, and he was expecting the ball the first time. It came the second time, and he couldn't hold it. So East will come up with the loose head and feed, 25 out from their own line.
Yes, just at this 28-minute mark, we've seen the play punctuated by two handling errors, inexplicably ill-conceived from both halves combinations, and rather than making the go forward through the exchanges that we saw in the last 12 minutes, they have just gone a little bit too lateral, Mike.
12 minutes gone. East leading Wynnum Manly 6 points to nil. East come up with the scrum feed and win, and they're about 23. I was going to say 23. Now they're pushed back 21 metres out from their own line. Mechanic Gibson goes into dummy half. He's looking both sides. He decides to come left. Gets it away there to Garbutt. Oh, solid contact there from Dane Carlaw. And I'm trying to see who the second player was underneath. They push him backwards. It was Grieve and Granville as well. Played back to Mechanic Gibson. There's a good charge there from Ratana, making up for that drop ball just a minute or so ago. Played back to Gibson. They put it through the hands now. Comes out wide there, and it's put down by the Tigers. Plenty of pressure there from the Wynnum Manly defenders. They've put it down and it's gone back. Wynnum Manly still lost about 25 metres after picking up the ball, but the referee will bring it back. A little bit of push and shove in back play, nothing to it. And referee Clayton Sharp will pack this scrum back down probably about 5-6 metres inside East Territory. So good attacking platform for the Seagulls and a similar type platform to the one which each scored back in the fifth minute.
Yes, so just over exuberance from Ken Bromwich there, and willingness to offload, which was done successfully by Bromwich earlier in this match, but it just wasn't on, Mike. He needed to just to take the tackle and build a platform for his attacking halves to get to their kick, but it didn't happen at all.
Scrum win to Wynnum Manly. It's with Loxley trying to get away from the defence. Geez, he's flirting dangerously close to that far sideline. Does well to come back infield. Played it back to Barnes. Barnes to skipper Luke Dalziel-Don. He'll take 10 metres. Steps off the left. Drags three defenders with him and he'll be stopped just 25 metres out from the Tigers' line. Plays it back to Granville. They come back across to the right. Now it's with Seamark. Seamark looking back inside to Grieve. Grieve coming back in. He needs to link up or straighten up. Now he straightens up, drives with the legs. They're finding it rather difficult to get him down. Eventually they'll wrestle him down right on the 20-metre line. They're only 20 out from the Tigers' line. East leading 6-0. Played back to Granville. Now it's with Fayud. Dummy steps. Now it's with Loxley. Great ball out there to the winger, Nat Barnes. He'll drive for the line. He won't quite get there. Some committed defence there from the Tigers. Four players in there to stop him. Just 2 metres out. Played it back now. Wallace, long ball. Fayud. Now it's with Tim Natush. His first touch this afternoon. Oh, solid contact there from Thorpe. Trying to stand in the tackle. It's with Granville. He offloads. Now it's with Dalziel-Don. And he'll take the tackle. Just 8 metres out from the line. Wynnum Manly. Highly on the attack here. He'll get up and play it back. It comes back across field to Fayud. Little grubber kick into the in goal. Doesn't quite get there. It's picked off there by the Tigers. It's Cody Walker. Accelerates back upfield. Out of one tackle. Out of two tackles. And eventually he'll take it. He's lost it. And referee should... What's he going to do? I tell you what.
He's called a knock on.
He's called a knock on.
Cody Walker will be furious.
Well, that's gone backwards towards the east line, so it's either knock on by
no
the Wynnum Manly Seagulls
or
play on. No
motion of that ball whatsoever. I cannot understand the officials coming to that decision. I mean, it's just perplexing. It really is.
It's gone Wynnum Manly's way. They'll come up with the loose head and feed, but perplexing
is
an
I'm not actually going to record that as an incomplete set because there was just no way that ball was propelled forward. It's puzzling.
Well,
startling.
Scrum to pack, 25 out from the east line.
In fact, it was Fayud who dislodged the ball.
Well, it was, and
should have been a penalty to the
east
Tigers.
Oh no, it was one on one, but if it didn't come off him, it should have been play on because it was picked up by a Tigers player. Now it's with Fayud after the scrum. He'll straighten up at in centre field, and eventually he'll be stopped about 23 metres out, right in line with the uprights. He'll get up and play it back to Granville. Has a little look right, goes left. Tim Natush running straight and hard, puts the head down, driving with the legs. He's always a handful when he's fired up, and he'll make it up to the 10-metre line. Wynnum Manly on the attack again. Granville, he has one player he doesn't pass to. Now it's with Seamark. They put it through the hands. Lockley just holds onto it, pulls it back in.
No, and he now he's called a knock on. There is no way that was a knock on.
Well, he was trying to pull it back in, but referee Clayton Sharp is adamant that it hit the ground before he regained control. I don't think Loxley's particularly happy with it. But
Clayton Sharp is actually premeditating what is happening before he's actually adjudicating on it, Mike, and it's just not accurate.
Well,
I've seen the replay here on the monitors, and there's no way that player should be punished for a turnover.
He seemed to pull it back in fairly
cleanly. He
pulled
it back in successfully. So, look, Clayton Sharp just needs to take stock here.
Walker to feed this scrum. In by Walker, out by Walker. Shane Moyler running straight and hard. Very close to the side of the scrum, but the Luke Dalziel-Don breaks out very quickly and he'll make the tackle. Moylan will be stopped about 21 metres out from his own line in centre field. Plays it back to McKenna Gibson, goes himself. Just off to the right, takes the tackle, and he'll make it out to the 30-metre line. Played it back to Walker. Now he's got Garbutt. Garbutt looks to offload out to the right, holds it himself, takes three defenders with him, and eventually he'll be stopped nine his own side of halfway. Played back to Gibson. They put it through the hands. We've got a change there for the Tigers. It looks like, is that Leifau Hala who's on the field? Or just double check. Oh, no, it was Thorpe that still had the ball. I thought it was number 15 that went down in the tackle. He's still in possession, though, and they're about 40 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line, right in centre field. Gibson back to Walker. He hoists a high bomb down towards that Canbar corner again, but Wynnum Manly winger drops back to take it there well, and it was Peter Gubb under plenty of pressure, and he'll take the tackle, seven out from his own line. Played it back now. Loxley goes himself, doesn't get away. Good marker defence there from the Tigers. Played it back again. Gubb goes for a little run himself, makes a bit more ground this time. He'll steal about 8 metres, but he does go towards centre field. Played back to Granville. They go left out there through Fayute. It's with Dalziel Don looking to link up. Does so. Wallace. Wallace out of two tackles. He's into the clear, Wallace. Looking to offload inside. Fayute puts it down. No, it bounces. It's play on. It's with Granville. Going for the line. The tackle will be complete. Only about 12 metres out from the line. Barnes, Fayute, Wynnum Manley under the pump at the moment. Back to Fayute. Now it's with Barnes. Barnes, he'll take the tackle 8 metres out. Last play for the Seagulls. He'll play it back to Fayute. Looks right, goes left. It's with Granville. Long ball out there to Dalziel Don. Looking for the winger. Goes himself, Dalziel Don. Reaching out, throws it back. It looks like it's been knocked on in the end. No, it was held on to. And it looks like it was Dan Wallace who's ended up with the ball. The tackle's made. Desperate defence from the Tigers. And magnificent attack from the Seagulls. The changeover, 2 metres out from the Tigers' line.
Oh, Dan Wallace, he is one of the strongest hard-running centres in the Queensland Cup. And he just tore the defence to pieces. And it was outstanding hands from Jake Granville to pick up that flick pass. But Dane Carlaw was remonstrating with Jacob Fayute. He missed a golden opportunity on the open side to exploit paper-thin defence. And I think he will lament that decision to go back to the left when the ball was contained by the East defence, Mike.
Well, Eddie Tautali with the ball at the moment gets out of a flimsy tackle before he's wrestled into the ground. Played back to Mechanic Gibson. Now comes back to Walker. There's the kick downfield. It's not a bad one. Going for the 40-20. We'll double check there. Troy, was it a 40-20?
I think it is, Mike.
I know he certainly found touch and he caught. It is. It's a 40-20. First one of the match. It's a terrific kick. He saw that the...
We're seeing the potential of this young man certainly starting to come to the fore in this match this afternoon.
He saw that Loxley and Gubb were up into the defensive line, so he kicked it over their head and it got the run on down on the grandstand side here at Langlands Park. So this scrum to pack ran about 12 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. First score through from Ipswich, and Tweed leading Ipswich 6-4 after 16 minutes. Here at Langlands Park, we've had 20 minutes of play. East leading Wynnum Manly 6-0 in what's starting to fire up into a fairly exciting match, Troy.
It is. It's only been marred by some indifferent interpretations from the referee. I have to say it because I can only see what I've witnessed, Mike, and they have to just watch the game more intently and not just premeditate decisions on the whim of match officials and sideline cohorts who aren't following the game intently.
Well, referee allowing water to be taken by players on both sides, so clearly it's an admission, I guess. Hang on, we just got
Mitch Garbutt is in the hand of trainer Matty Williamson at the moment.
He took that second ruck up off their own line. I'm just looking at that left shoulder of his, Troy. Is it hanging there? Is it the left shoulder?
Limp, isn't it, Mike?
Well,
so there could be a devastating loss in terms of genuine size from the Tigers pack if this player cannot take any more part in the match this afternoon.
He's been a good performer in the opening 20 minutes here at Langlands Park this afternoon. 20 minutes gone. East leading Wynnum Manly 6-0. This scrum to pack 11 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. This is your BayFM call team live on 100.3, heart and soul of the Bay, and we're at Langlands Park at Stones Corner this afternoon. Big round 16 match between the Wynnum Manly Seagulls and the East Tigers, and both sides showing already in the opening exchanges that they're willing to have a go and back their own skills, because this ball is moving end to end and side to side every set. Certainly a good crowd here at Langlands Park this afternoon. A credit to the Tigers and their promotional team. Scrum, one there by East. Now it's in the hands there of Thompson. Dummies looking to hook up. Goes back behind the winger there, Eddie Tautali, the try scorer the first time for the Tigers. And the defence moves up on him very quickly to wrap him up this time. Now it comes across field. It's a good charge there from Ratana. He goes straight and hard, makes it up to within 10 metres of the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Gibson. Another change there for the Tigers. Number 14's come on. That's big Jordan McLean. He's the Melbourne Storm signing there, Troy. Certainly got a little bit of size about him. Very intimidating. Tackle made about 5 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Gibson goes back to the right. Good long pass. Let bounce there by Kaufman. Kaufman holding it up there. Certainly getting plenty of time. The East halves there, Troy. Ball kept alive. Nat Barnes and Tautali going for the ball. It comes loose. Kaufman dives on the loose ball about 3 metres from the right-hand sideline. He'll get up and play it back to Tautali. Coming back across field through Gibson. Now it's with Walker. Walker steps back to the right. Stabs a little grubber kick off his left foot. It's not a particularly good one. Taken there by Loxley. Loxley slips over when he comes back into the field of play. Tackle will be made 10 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line, but they're in possession. East leading 6-0. Played back there to Seamark. He finds a hard running Gubb, who's just picked up and driven back. He'll be driven back 8 metres. Eventually the tackle will be made. 5 out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Granville. Now it's with Dane Carlaw. Has his right leg held on to desperately there by an East defender. It's McKenna Gibson. Slowed him down long enough for the big forwards to come through and finish off the tackle. Now it's with Ben Shea, who's on the field there for the Seagulls. He just runs straight and hard, draws plenty of defence there from the Tigers, stopped 18 out from his own line. Looks like John Torrio's on the field there as well. So
the coach is ramping up the changes.
Yeah,
Mike.
Changes thick and fast at the moment. Now it's with Loxley, gets away from the first tackler. Oh, he gets up after the second tackle. The ball comes loose. It's dived on there by Kaufman. Terrible mistake there from the Seagulls, and he's come up with the ball about 34 metres out from the Seagulls line. Played back to Tautali. Now it's with Big McLean. McLean going straight and hard. Looked to offload for a second there. Decided to hold on to it, and eventually the tackle will be made. 26 out from the line. Played back to Gibson. Gets the ball back inside there to Ratana. Ratana coming back to the right, and the tackle will be made. He's only 19 out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Gibson. Now it's with Walker. What will we see this time? Comes back across field. Good ball away there to Gravesky. It's put down in the tackle. Picked up straight away there by Moon, but Graevsky slow to get up. We'll just make sure he's all right there, Troy.
He's reeled out of the collision there, Mike.
I didn't think there was anything in it. Was it a head clash, perhaps?
Yes, I think you're exactly right. I think
there was nothing untoward in the tackle, but he's just there on one knee at the moment. The trainer's with him. Referee Clayton Sharpie stopped the clock. But
the ball was legitimately dislodged there, so I can actually give some kudos to the official. He's actually made the right decision there, Mike.
Well, I just watched the replay there, Troy. There certainly didn't look to be anything in it. And I'm just wondering if there was a little bit of claret spilled. He's back up onto his feet now. Krajewski.
This game's being played at a frenetic pace, Mike.
Well, I think Wynnum Manly will be thankful for a couple of these hold-ups, Troy, because East have certainly ramped up the intensity and the pace of this match. The scrum, won there by Wynnum Manly. It's with Gubb, straight and hard, drives with his legs, doesn't get too far. Eventually he'll be put down 15 out from his own line. It's with Torrio, steps off the left, the defence comes up at him, look to offload out the back, elected correctly to hold onto the ball, and he'll take the tackle. Played back to Granville, almost goes himself. Now he gets it there to Carlaw, offloads out the back, Ben Shea. Ben Shea picks it up, goes straight and hard. Walker's got him, and taking his legs underneath him there is Leon Panapa. Gets up, plays it back there to Granville. Now it's with Carlaw again, driving straight and hard. That's what the Seagulls fans like to see. Takes about 10 metres straight up the middle of the field. He'll get up and play it there by Granville. He's very quick out of half, Granville. Looking to link up, does so. Finds a hard running Wallace out of two tackles. Still going, Wallace. Now he hooks up across field. Fayoud, it's with Dalziel Don. Actually, it was Grieve, and it went to Moon. Now it's out there to Peter Gubb. Gubb, he'll eventually take the tackle 16 metres out from the east line. Can Wynnum Manly put on some points? Long ball back at crossfield to Seamark. There's the kick. It's not bad. The chase is good. Comes off Wallace's hands. It goes backwards. It's play on. Picked up by Wynnum Manly. It'll be a try.
Yes.
Magnificent try. Broken play. Nack Barnes comes up with the try. Wynnum Manly are back into this match. East lead Wynnum Manly 6-4. We've had 24 minutes of play.
Well, I tell you, Mike, the manifesto of Ross Strudwick is like the ghost has reappeared at Langlands Park from way back in 1994, because we're just seeing sweeping ball movement from one side of the field to the other, some sparkling attack through the hands of the Wynnum Manly Seagulls, isolating the East defenders, getting the two-on-one, and then on the fifth tackle option, we saw Jacob Fayoud put up a pinpoint accurate kick. It was knocked backwards. Was it by John Grieve, Mike, I think?
No, it was Dan Wallace.
Dan
went
Wallace,
up to take
yes.
it.
And Dan Wallace made a great break on the open side when the ball then came back to the western side of the field, so he's had two touches in the space of 60 seconds, knocked the ball back, and then it was just the ever-present vigilance of Nathanael Barnes, who's then crashed over. He's very physically strong for his size, Nat Barnes. He took three defenders to subdue him on his way to the line, and it was a great performance from Nat Barnes to secure the 4 points to the Wynnum Manly Seagulls. Sparkling attack from the Seagulls.
Magnificent. Matt Seamark setting this ball for the conversion. Right on the 20-metre line, and around about 4 to 5 metres in from the car park sideline. We've had 25 minutes of play here at Langlands Park, and it's 6-4. Seamark's conversion could equal the scoreline as we look at it there, Troy. Certainly nothing between the two sides, and it's a good hit bat by the Seagulls, because really East have dominated probably marginally more in the first 15 minutes of play.
I agree, Mike.
Here's Seamark's conversion. Takes his time, Seamark. He's matured into a very solid kicker. Moves in, this breeze strikes up again. It's not bad, it's curving back around. It's come just to the left of the uprights. Touch judges wave it away. So the conversion attempt unsuccessful, and the Eastern Suburbs Tigers leading Wynnum Manly 6-4. And we've had 26 minutes of play here at Langlands Park. Good crowd in here at Langlands Park today, Troy, for the local grudge match.
A great crowd for a Saturday, Mike.
And a very important match too, this one, Troy.
We're certainly seeing a contrast here.
Penalty!
Pulled out the old chestnut, the referee chestnut. The penalty from the kickoff, Mike. We're seeing it all from Clayton Sharp this afternoon.
Next there'll be a scrum penalty.
Oh,
there'll
be a scrum penalty. Somebody will go to the bin.
Well, they do warn the players, Troy, to time their runs these days, so there's really no excuse.
They're not consistent about it, Mike.
No,
I mean, it's just on a whim. That's what just frustrates me. It's just on a whim. Oh, look, we'll give a penalty here.
Clayton Sharp gives the penalty. Wynnum Manly, kick for touch from right on halfway. Seamark takes it, and he'll find touch around about 27 metres out from the Tigers' line. East leading Wynnum Manly at the moment, 6-4. Granville takes the tap. Straight away finds Greaves. Steps off the right. Now he straightens up. Plenty of orange and black in there to stop him. And they'll put him down about 10 metres in from the sideline and 20 metres out from the try line. Plays it back to Granville. They go across field through Seamark. He's got Greave running back inside. Greave won't go through there. And actually, it's not Greave, it's Ben Shea actually
the
there,
line
Troy.
At pace, Mike.
It was. I know you've been a little bit critical in the past. Now it's with Seamark out there through Fayoud. Fayoud gets a good ball away there to, that's with the halfback there, Matt Seamark. No, is that number 7?
No, that was Sean Loxley.
It was Loxley. I thought it was 7. It was number 1 on his jersey there, Troy. I was looking at the colour there and I thought that's not right. Granville with the ball goes across there to Fayoud. Fayoud finds a hard running Dalziel Don going for the line. Won't get there. He'll be stopped about a metre and a half out from the east line. Played back to Torrio. They come back to the right. It's with Fayoud. There's the kick across field. Not bad. The chase is pretty good, but it'll be taken fairly easily there by Cody Walker. And East out of trouble again. He'll run up and take a quick tap. It's play on. Straight away.
Oh no!
He's taken the tap.
He must know this game's being live streamed by the Tigers because he's certainly making a star-studded performance this afternoon.
Oh, he's brought
of
it
his
back.
Own making, Mike.
He's going to let them have the tap again. Geez, Troy, I thought for a second he was going to take it off him. The tap eventually taken there. East in possession. And they're about 27 metres out from their own line. Played back to Gibson. Gibson gets a good ball away there to Panapa, the former Wynnum player. He just drives straight and hard. They wrestle him into the ground. Played back to Gibson. It comes back across field. Now it's with McLean. McLean turns his back around. Troy gets the arms free but doesn't get the pass away. Played back to Gibson. They're inside Wynnum Manly territory.
Good
charge there by Bromwich, but solid contact there from the Wynnum Manly defence. Now it comes through the hands. It's with Zgrajewski. Zgrajewski injured a little bit earlier and just running a little bit tentatively at the moment. He'll be stopped about 16 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Now it's with Shane Moreland, dummy half. Grubber kick through. Chasing it back there is Wynnum Manly. We'll just see if it's been kept in play. No, it looks like it's gone dead first. So Wynnum Manly will come out for the 20-metre optional kick restart. Nat Barnes, quick tap. Goes himself. He'll take 10 metres straight up the centre of the field. 13 metres. Gets it out of the danger zone there for the Seagulls. He'll play it back to Torrio. Torrio looks right, holds it himself, goes back towards the left, straight and hard, driving with the legs. The marker defence is good. Offloads out the back. It's with Gubb. He'll split them. Gubb straight up the middle of the field. They won't stop him. Yes, they will. Oh, the desperate defence there of Thompson. Rode him into the ground. 5 metres out from the line. Fayoud, dummy half, going himself. Doesn't quite get to the line. I thought he got across the line. Referee says he'll have to play it. A metre out now. Plays it back to Gubb. Needs to settle now, Wynnum Manly. Comes back across field. It's with Seamark looking to link up. Couldn't do so. The tackle's made about 10 metres out. He'll get up and play it back to Clayton. Clayton goes left. Long pass. 25 metres out there to Mr. Nobody. Picked up by Dalziel Don. Looking to link up. It's with Dan Wallace. To Loxley. To Barnes. He'll score try number 2 for the Seagulls. The corner post gets taken out, but it looked to me like he was in fairly. He is. The try's awarded. Barnes is in for number 2. That's try number 101 in his career. Failed to mention it a little bit earlier there, Troy. 30 minutes into this match, Wynnum have scored twice. They lead 8-6 with a kick to come.
Well, look, just an innocuous play from the Wynnum Manly Seagulls on the fifth tackle option because Matt Seamark was caught on the fifth tackle, had to play the ball. The ball came back, as you said, to Claude Rains in a starring role
Claude Rains
in the back line. And then just a great... patience and anticipation of not knocking the ball on by Luke Dalziel-Don. We saw it go through sets of hands. One of the great transformations of this young player in Dan Wallace is that I was very critical in the first part of the season that he wasn't passing the ball. He has now passed it three times and has just opened up opportunities for his outside backs to score. So Dan Wallace is certainly metamorphosing into a very skilled player and a rounded player on the back of his experiences with the Wynnum Manly Seagulls this year. But it's just the spontaneity. There was a meritorious aspect to that game, but it was still built on great foundations with the way that they swept downfield and that great break from the winger in Gubb, which laid the foundations, a 60-metre sprint, and it was a wonderful try-saving tackle.
I thought
tackle
he was going to go
Thompson.
All the way too.
It
Corey
like
Thompson
got there,
chased
Corey Thompson
down.
Has a great turn of pace and commitment to get to the defender.
Here's Seamark's conversion. 23 metres out. A metre from the touchline on the car park side here at Langlands Park. Wynnum Manly leading 8-6, looking to extend that by another 2 points. Here's Seamark's conversion. Not bad. Gets under it well. It's going to get caught in the breeze. It's not going to make the distance.
He's not reading the southeasterly, is he?
No, it's been waved away. And the ball stops dead right in front of the upright. So after 31 minutes of play here at Langlands Park, Wynnum Manly leading East 8 points to 6. And boy, oh boy, are we seeing some football here this afternoon.
A cracking game, Mike.
A cracking game.
If the referee just relents from ingratiating himself on this fixture, it will be one of the games of the season.
Well, they did it earlier in the season. Could they be about to do it again? There's the kickoff. Taken there well there by Torrio. Gets the ball back across field. Looks like it's with Gubb for the first hit up back upfield. He'll bring it up to 16 metres out from his own line. Now it's with Ben Shea. Straight and hard. Runs into the shoulder there of McLean. They slow him down. They're finding it difficult to get him onto the ground. Now they roll him over onto his back. And he'll be made to play at about 28 out from his own line. Now it's with Gubb again. Gubb looking to offload out the back. Can't get the ball away. They wrap him up fairly quickly. Tackle's made. Now it comes back across field. They cut out to Fayou. Now it's with Wallace. Wallace causing absolute mayhem out wide there for the Seagulls. The Tigers defence struggling in the backs to keep him under control. Now it's with Loxley. Loxley takes about 16, 17 metres from dummy half, and he'll be stopped 30 out from the line. Can Wynnum Manly go in again? It's with Seamark. Stabs a little grubber kick through. It'll pull up well in the end goal, and it's taken dead there. In fact, it was shepherded dead. No, it was taken dead. The referee, gee, I tell you what, Corey Thompson thought he'd the ball had gone dead before he touched it. Referee Clayton Sharp said, no, boy, you're going to drop it out. So East forced to drop out from underneath their own uprights. 6.5 minutes out from half time. Wynnum Manly leading East 8 points to 6. Unbelievable.
Mike,
it looked to me like it was
dead.
He's
refereeing
but
this game in the parallel universe. He's just not here. He's not in the physical world at the moment.
Good drop out there from McKenna. Gibson over halfway. Gets the bounce on as well. It's taken there by Gubb. He'll run it back just into East territory. There's the chasers. In fact, he'll make it up to right on the 10-metre line. So they're 40 metres out from the East line. Eventually, he'll play it back to Torrio. Torrio comes right there. Good charging run there from Clayton. Clayton straight up the middle of the field. Has his legs taken out underneath him by Zgrajewski. Played it back to Torrio. Straightens up now. Ben Shea drops a shoulder in. Driving with the legs. Ben Shea takes another 8 metres. He'll be stopped just 7 out from the Tigers line. He'll play it back to Torrio. He looks right. Goes left. Goes himself. Long ball. Fayoud. Now it's with Dalziel-Don. Throws it. Bounces on the ground. Picked up there by Barnes looking for number 3. He won't go through there. Plenty of golden black in there to stop him. 8 metres out from the line. Wynnum Manly on the attack. Played back to Wallace. To Fayoud. Now it's with Clayton. Straight and hard. Oh, good solid defence there from Bromwich to make the tackle. They're still trying to get him down on the ground. Eventually they do. McKenna Gibson goes in to take his legs out underneath him. Now it's with Fayoud. Dribbles. Oh, kick through.
Kick.
And it looks like it's Dan Wallace who's come up with the try. Follows the kick magnificently. Wallace is in. Wynnum Manly their third try. They lead 12 points to 6. We're 5 minutes out from halftime.
Oh, that was a magnificently placed kick from Jacob Fayoud. We're seeing alternating kickers, and it's just mesmerising and confusing the East defensive line. It was a great defensive set from the Tigers, but just that deft kick from Jacob Fayoud was able to pierce the defence of the East Tigers, and then a fast-finishing Dan Wallace has crashed onto that ball and secured another four-pointer for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls. Excellently constructed try from Jacob Fayoud. He is just really embellishing his skills here this afternoon and working seamlessly with Matt Seamark on those fifth tackle options, Mike.
Score through from Ipswich. Tweed Seagulls leading Ipswich 10-8 after 30 minutes, and a score through from Toowoomba as well. The under-16 Maroons are leading New South Wales Country 16-10 at half-time. So good to see the young fellas
well done, boys.
Also battling on with the success of the Queensland residents in Origin during the week, so I'm sure they would have used that as part of their motivation this afternoon. But 10-8 Tweed leading Ipswich. Looks like it's a tight game out there, Troy. I did tip Ipswich this week. They were my roughie of the week. And like I said earlier, I've got them penciled in as potential premiership threats.
This is without
Don Malone as well.
Yes. So it's an excellent first half performance from the Ipswich Jets. They were certainly disrupted by the loss of Donald Malone.
Seamark has this ball set, 10 metres in from touch, 20 metres out. This is his third kick from out there, Troy.
Now he's got to read the southeast league.
So you could throw a TKZ over the three spots.
Otherwise, we'll see it go sail over the post again, Mike.
Seamark taking his time. The breeze has just died down at the moment. Important kick there, Troy, too, to put him out from that converted try. This is a better effort, and the flags go up. He's successful for his first kick of the afternoon. One from three, Matt Seamark. Wynnum Manly move out now. They lead Eastern Suburbs 14 points to 6. We've got 3.5 minutes left until half-time here at Langlands Park. And this is your BayFM call team live on 100.3, heart and soul of the Bay. Live local rugby league on local radio. East kicking off. Another long kick down towards that Canbar corner again. It'll be taken there by Tarillo, and straight away gives it a hard-running Clayton. Clayton straight back towards centre field. The tackle will be made. He'll be stopped about 18 metres out from his own line right in centre field. Tarillo finds out. Is that Matt Smith who's on the field now, Troy? Just failed to see his number there. He gets up and plays it back now. Going from dummy half now. It's off to the left. Ben Shea gets the arm free. Nowhere to go. They ride him into the ground, and Leon Panapa takes his legs out underneath him. Played back to Tarillo. They keep going the left. Fayu, Dalziel Don steps off the left. Can't get away from the defence. Eager East defence will wrap him up. They know he's a danger man. He'll get up and play it back to Tarillo. Coming back towards the open side. Now it's with Matt Smith straight and hard. He makes it up to about 2 metres shy of halfway. Played back to Tarillo to Fayu. There's the kick. It's not a particularly good one. Read well up by Thompson. Takes it at pace. Slips over as he brings it back upfield. And he'll make it to pretty well right on the 30-metre line. Out from their own line in the shadows of the grandstand. Now it comes back across field to Moylan. Moylan accelerates. He's certainly making some ground. Troy's a very classy runner. Shay Moylan, the former premiership player with the Seagulls. Wynnum Manly players pleading to the touch judge for something there. Nothing's forthcoming. Played it back to Walker. Walker gets a good ball away there to Zgrajewski. Zgrajewski looks like he's offloaded back inside. He's still in possession. Five their own side of halfway. McKenna Gibson. Good ball away there to Stephen Thorpe. Thorpe up over halfway. He gets up and plays it down. Oh, it's come off the foot, but a penalty. Not for letting the East player play the ball cleanly. Came off his foot, so it would have been play on anyway. But that's only the second penalty of the match there, Troy. Penalties one apiece as we speak. But this gives East a good attacking platform. This kick for touch, only going to be 25 metres out from the line.
Again, I think the Tigers will be quite aggrieved with the performance of the match official this afternoon, Michael.
Moylan takes the tap, goes himself down the grandstand side, takes an easy 10 metres. Fairly lacklustre line speed from the Wynnum Manly defence. Played back to McKenna Gibson, 20 metres off to the right, out there through Thorpe to Walker. Kaufman. Now it's with Thompson. Thompson wrapped up there by Fayud. Wrestles him into the ground. 26 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played it back now. It's with Kaufman. Running at will. Comes back across field. They let it go and bounce. Picked up there by Zgrajewski. Takes it ugly. Breaks through two tackles. They won't stop him. He's too big. And Zgrajewski will score the try underneath the post for the Tigers. They're back into this match. It's 14-10 with a kick to come. And with only 50 seconds left on the clock, I think it's safe to say, Troy, that Paul Green will not be happy with the Wynnum Manly closeout of this half.
Well, look, this was an opportunist moment from Gradinski, and the player that fell off that tackle just evaded in the replay on the monitor here, but dare to say it may have been Matt Seamark that was isolated in that situation. But again, it's just the onus on the ball carrier to run at full speed, because again, those spontaneous moments can arise when, as we saw, it was a pass that was scorching the cooch at one moment and then just bounced up, and he was able to break free of that isolated defender and score under the post. A defining moment in the dying embers of this first half of the East Tigers. That player still splayed on the ground on the replay we're seeing here, it's not Matt Seamark. No, it is Matt Seamark. It is Matt Seamark, because Loxley is watching with great trepidation of Gradinski's run under the post. So, yes, an isolated defender right on half-time. And as you said, Paul Green will be just ropeable with that lack of defensive commitment from the Seagulls. Again, a much bigger man just trampling over the top of a small halfback. He should have been assisted
by
the
centres.
Stop the legs, Troy. Yeah.
Stop the legs. Anyway, it's half-time. Wynnum Manly leading the Eastern Suburbs Tigers here at Langlands Park. 14 points to 12. He's coming up with a try to Gravesky right on half-time. Walker's conversion successful from right in front. So only 2 points in it. And this match open for the grabbing at this stage. Troy, the... Yeah, the Wynnum Manly supporters, good travellers, especially when they're rivalry type matches, yes. The matches against Souths at Davies and of course East here, and then of course the classic, the Wynnum Manly Redcliffe matches.
Yes.
Wynnum Manly, notoriously good travellers and certainly making plenty of noise. I can hear while we cover the game there, Troy, I can hear the banter going on up in the grandstand both ways. One group of supporters will say something and then the response will come, and it's been going on all through this match. And not unlike the game itself there, Troy, the Tigers, they delivered a knockout blow early in the match, and it really set the Seagulls right back on their backsides. And they had to start from scratch again, and they battled through it, and they weathered the Tigers' storm, and East came close on one or two occasions, and then they came up with those two tries in quick succession there from Nat Barnes, two tries within 6 minutes in the 25th and 30th minute, and that really sort of put their stamp on that sort of that later period in the second half. But then once again, one mistake, that's all it took, and East came hammering back, and Zgrajewski scored that try right on the half-time break, and it's anyone's game.
It is anybody's game. As I said in my review of the first half, Mike, I'm just so impressed with the progress and evolution of Dan Wallace's game, because I was a little critical of his inability to pass in the early part of the season, but now he's actually looking, drawing players and hitting blokes on the chest with accurate passes, and he's doing his job as a centre. He's making those metres to put players, support players in try-scoring situations, and he's done that with great efficiency here at Langlands Park this afternoon.
Well, Wynnum Manly, one win ahead of Redcliffe on the table there, Troy, and we expect Redcliffe to defeat South tomorrow, but East, they're in the middle of a bit of a bun fight there. Tweed Heads on 21, East on 20, Ipswich on 18, and North on 17. So it's, I'm sure that Coach Troy McCarthy is really... You know, they fell aside with that one game against Tweed, but then they came back and hammered the premiership, nailed it home.
Well, I also just add to that cluster of size that you mentioned, that the super coach made the comment a couple of weeks ago, with North's featuring in the Channel 9 games of the Intrust Super Cup, that she is convinced that they are genuine premiership contenders if they can keep the core group of those players that have been moving between the Brisbane Broncos and North over the Origin period, and they should get that semblance of stability back in their lineup. And she thinks they are a genuine threat to the Queensland Cup in 2012, Mike.
Well, East to kick off for the second half. They'll be running from the scoreboard end of Langlands Park. Wynnum Manly will get first use of the ball, and they'll be running out from the clubhouse. And the referee just moving off to one side, ready to blow time on. He's already checked with both captains. Only a second or two away, and there goes the whistle for the start of the second half. It's a long kickoff there, a high kickoff there, which is hung up there nicely, taken there by Seamark. And that's big. Clayton, I think, brings the first one back, hammered down, and he'll be tackled about 12 out from his own line. Now it's with Ben Shea. Good hard run there, Troy, and it's good to see that Ben Shea's matured into a fairly rugged footballer, making plenty of metres for the Seagulls. Now it's with Matt Smith. Matt Smith straight off the left there, and he'll take about another 10 metres. Mechanic Gibson's got his legs to slow him down. He'll play it just his own side of halfway. Torrio comes left through Fayud. Now it's with... I thought that was Dalziel Don. It is Dalziel Don. Stepped off the right, but eventually he's taken the tackle. Very slow play the ball. Pretty well on halfway. Torrio, Fayud. Now it's out there through Matt Smith again, and he's thumped down fairly ruggedly just inside East territory. Played back to Torrio. Comes back to Fayud for the kick. There's the kick going for that corner. He'll find touch. Don't think it was a 40-20 there, Troy. Didn't look from where he actually kicked the ball, but I think he was just on halfway. So East will come up with the loose head and feed 10 metres out from their own line, and a fairly competent start to the second half by the Seagulls.
Yes, we've seen the bench players still participating at the opening exchanges in the second half. So Coach Paul Green has decided that his majority of his starting pack will remain on the bench. And as you say, Matt Smith, certainly a willing runner into that defensive line. And as you say, a maturing Ben Shea is certainly making some telling contributions in terms of gaining metres for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls around the fringes of the ruck, Mike.
Interesting, Troy. Dan Wallace has gone into lock there for the Seagulls. So I assume Luke Dalziel-Don is standing wide. They've won the scrum there, the Tigers, but they'll get pushed backwards and eventually this tackle will be made just 5 metres out from their line. Walker finds hard running. I think that is that Ratana that's taken the ball up. He brings it up out of the danger zone, 15 out from the line. Now it's with McKenna Gibson. He gets a good ball away there to, I think it's Zgrajewski. Can't quite see his number there, Troy, but he'll be stopped about 30 metres out from their own line. McKenna Gibson dumbing left and right. He was looking for someone to pass to and no one was there to help him. He'll get up and play it back there to Walker. Walker goes himself, goes for a little run just up over halfway. He'll be made to play it 2 metres inside Seagulls territory. Plays it back to McKenna Gibson. He'll kick it from dummy half. It's not a bad one. He won't find grass. Dropping back there is Loxley. Gets it away to Barnes. Barnes will run it out of the danger zone. Straightens up now and brings it up to about 23 metres out right in centre field. That's where the tackle will be made. He'll play it back to Fayoud, screaming on the left. Now it's with Wallace. Wallace, handful every time he's touched the ball in this match so far. Brings it up to 30 metres out from the Seagulls' line. Torrio gets a good ball away there to Matt Smith. Matt Smith straight and hard, and he'll eventually be pulled down seven, his own side of halfway. Played back to Torrio. Now it's with Clayton. Clayton bounces his way up over halfway. Turns his back in. I thought for a second he was going to offload, but he decided to hold it. Torrio out there to Shea. Shea looks right, holds it himself, comes back infield, still driving with the legs. Takes it up well inside East territory. And this will be the last one for the Seagulls. It comes across to Fayoud. There's the kick. What will we see? It's a high bomb. It's not bad. The chase is pretty good from the Seagulls. Drops back there magnificently as Thompson takes it under pretty good pressure there from the Seagulls, and he'll be made to play it just a metre out from his own line.
Corey Thompson, again, another player that has matured after his initial forays into the Queensland Cup. He is certainly a very reliable and self-assured custodian, Mike.
Moylan will be made to play it. Three tackles down. The Tigers are only five out from their own line. Comes back across field. Oh, geez, I thought that ball went forward for a second. Eventually, he offloads it. And the Wynnum Manly defence equal to the task. And they'll be made to play it. 14 out from their own line. Played it back now. It's with... actually, it's a penalty. What's he got him for there, Troy?
Offside,
just offside.
Mike.
Just offside, a blatant offside, 10 metres away from the play.
Goodness
the ball.
Me.
Oh, well, there's the penalty. That's only the third penalty of the match. It does go to the Tigers, but this will allow East to get out of their own danger zone. There's the kick for touch. It's not a bad one. And it'll find touch about 8 metres their own side of halfway. Tap to be taken, 10 metres infield. It'll be taken there by Kaufman. Kaufman gets the ball away there. It's... looks like it's a charge there by Ratana. Is that Ratana with the ball? Just over halfway. I thought he was on the bench for a second.
It's
Bromwich. It's actually Kenny Bromwich. The ball's with Harla now. Harla, he's only 38 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. He's holding on to Smith's arm in the play of the ball. Now it comes back there to big Jordan McLean. Geez, he's a big unit there, Troy. He's very hard to handle. Played back to McKenna Gibson now. He goes across to the left, looking to link up again. He had no runners whatsoever. He was isolated and he's having plenty to say because of it. Kaufman out there to Walker. Turns it back inside to Mr. Nobody. Going back to pick it up is Thompson. Thompson saves the day there for the Tigers, just runs it back up, and he'll be stopped 22 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Now it's there with that's a forward pass from Panapa.
No, he's,
sure.
Let, it
no,
go,
he's
Mike.
Let it go. Did that come off a Wynnum Manly player? I know he reached out just from here. It just looked like it was forward, but if you think it looked good, I'm happy to go with it. But East have scored. That is not the start to the second half that Wynnum Manly wanted, but... it's certainly one that East wanted, and they're back in front, 16-14 with a kick to come. We've had around about 6 minutes of the second half.
Sleight of hand moment here from Leon Panapa, a man that is just blessed with an array of ball skills which can be extremely dangerous in a lethargic defensive line, and that's the only word I can describe. The Wynnum Manly defence was just lethargic and inept in the way that they were committing to that defence of Leon Panapa, because he came at the line at pace and he used his evasive skills, stepped off his foot and then created a one-handed pass situation. And again, Wynnum Manly just not interested in defending in that
period leading up to the try, Mike, and culpability is just with them. And we're looking at a replay here. Panapa goes to the line, he takes two defenders, and then just grabbing tackles, which
can't stop Walker. He'll go through and score.
That's an outstanding backup from Cody Walker, also to instigate the potential pass from Leon Panapa, or anticipate the pass from Panapa, because he has an ability to just drag defenders with him. He's a strong man, he has a fairly low centre of gravity, and he's done it all to set up this try, Mike.
Walker, third conversion this afternoon from three attempts, and East move out now. They lead Wynnum Manly by 18 points to 14. We've had 7 minutes of this second half.
Just complacency and ineptitude in their defensive commitment, Mike, has led to that opportunity for Panapa to put the Tigers back in front very early in the second half. And I think Paul Green will be very frustrated with their lack of urgency in their defensive line speed.
Matt Seamark back for the kick, telling his players to make sure they're onside at the kickoff, because we've seen a penalty for that already this afternoon. Taken well there by Tautali. Tautali, the East winger, goes back across field, doesn't try anything flash, and takes the tackle 20 metres out from his own line. Played back to Gibson. Gibson gets a good ball away to one of his forward runners. He brings it up to about 21 metres out from his own line, and that's Jordan McLean who plays it. Now comes back across field. Looks like that's Seth Bromwich there, Troy, with the ball. I just looked away for a second. I was looking for Paul Green. It was actually Harler.
Could be Luke
played
Harler,
back to
yes.
Nobody. He's still in possession. It's with Tautali. Tautali, nowhere to go. He's stepping left, stepping right, looking for someone to pass to. No one there. Played back to Gibson. Goes for a little scoot himself from dummy half. Steals 15 metres. Well and truly inside Wynnum Manly territory. Played back to Walker now, to Kaufman. Long ball out to the left now. It's with, that's Walker now. There's the kick downfield. It's not a particularly good one. Goes straight down the throat of Loxley. Loxley will take it easily. About 8 metres out from his own line. Gets up, pushes again. Geez, that's almost moving off the mark there, Troy. Played back to Moon, who I thought's had a pretty quiet game there today. Goes from dummy half out to the right, or eventually he's made to play it. Now it's there with Gubb, that's Peter Gubb. He brings it up to about 21 metres out from his own line. Played back to Torrio. Now it's with Big Charlie Gubb. Charlie, straight and hard. He knows which way to go. He'll steal about 11 metres, and eventually he'll be wrapped up and dropped onto his back, 30 metres out in centre field. Played back to Torrio. It's is that Carlaw back on the field?
No, that's still Matty Smith.
Oh, no, that's Matty Smith again. Geez, I saw Carlaw warming up on the sideline. I thought maybe Paul Green might have brought him on after that try, but obviously he's going to stick to his game plan. That kick going in goal. In fact, it'll go touch in goal, so it'll come back for a 20-metre optional kick for the Tigers. And not a particularly good end to that set there, Troy. They made the ground, but just no kick at the end of it.
They made telling ground around the ruck, and again, we're just seeing a lack of precision from the kickers in the first part of the second half, Mike. And with a 19-14 deficit, they need to do better than just putting the ball over the dead ball line or the touch and goal.
McLean with the ball, plays it back to Gibson. Gibson gets good ball away. Oh, it's popped out there magnificently. Tigers still in possession. Now they put it through the hands. It comes out there through the centre there with Shane Newman. Newman, eventually he'll take the tackle, only about 22 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line, but the Tigers on the attack again. Played back to Walker, out there to Kaufman. Kaufman put it through the hands, out there through Panapa, and it ends up out wide there with Shea Moylan. Moylan looking to link up, gets it back inside there to Tongia. Tongia goes straight at the line. He won't go through there. He knew he'd run out of space. He couldn't go down that short side because he would have just been pushed into the fence. Played back to Moylan. Now it comes back across field. It's with Kaufman. He's looking to link up. Gibson. Now it comes back. This is looking more dangerous. It's with Bromwich. Bromwich turns around the back to offload out the back. Can't do so. Wynnum Manly defence moves up and knocks him down. Charlie Gubb was the man who made it. Gibson runs to the line, gets a great ball away to Panapa, and Panapa will crash over for the Tigers. What a terrifically set up try there for the East Tigers. They caught Wynnum Manly short at marker defence. Panapa read it well. He hit the line. He knew where to go. The East Tigers are in again. They're moving away with this game. It's 22 points to 14 with a kick to come. We've had 11 minutes of the second half.
Well, I was a little critical of Shane Newman, but just looking on the live stream replay there, he showed great just constructiveness in terms of the way that he held the play up, because there was a defender from the Wynnum Manly Seagulls looming. He had a man rushing up on the inside, and I thought he could have given the pass earlier, but he just showed some patience and some composure in the way that he went to ground, and on the back of that they were able to construct that magnificent. McKenna Gibson, he just seemed to have an eternity to drift across. And the players, the Wynnum Manly players that were on the short side of the field, just did not move up with any kind of fervour whatsoever. We're seeing the replay here. McKenna Gibson is just going to drift across field. He's taken Charlie Gubb and Jacob Fayud. Fayud got back, and it was just a forlorn hope because Leon Panapa at pace was never going to be stopped 5 metres from the line. And it was just a wonderfully intelligent move from McKenna Gibson to drift and take those two players across field.
Walker's conversion is successful. Two more points. He's kicked four from four this afternoon. East leading Wynnum Manly now 24-14, and there's two tries the difference. But certainly a flat Wynnum Manly coming out after the break, after such a great second part of the first half there, Troy. Was that try right on half time? Just seems to have taken the wind out of their sails.
I'm quite speechless as the lack of intensity and the lack of fervour and enthusiasm for the Seagulls. They just seem to have gone into some kind of trance, Mike, and they're just waiting on their line for the Tigers runners to hit the ball at pace.
Tigers bring it back fairly ruggedly, 20 metres out from their own line. It's a bit more fired up defence there from the Seagulls. And Tim Natush going to be lucky not to be penalised. He held him down for an eternity. Now it comes across field. It's there with, I think that's Bromwich now with the ball, and he'll be stopped about 22 out from their own line. He'll play it back to Gibson. Gibson's got McLean on his left. McLean turns the shoulder. Plenty of defence in there to meet him, red and green. And eventually they'll wrestle him to ground 10, his own side of halfway. They play it back to Gibson now to put it through the hands. It comes back to, I think that's not the try scorer there. That's Bromwich again, I think, with the ball, is it? No. Just trying to read their numbers there. Try. That's not... Anyway, I've lost the number there completely there, Troy, but he's still in possession, 10 metres inside Wynnum Manly territory. There's the kick downfield there by Walker. It'll just make it back shy of the try line. Picked up there by Peter Gubb, runs it back fairly ferociously, brings it up to 9 metres out from his own line right in centre field. Nat Barnes will take the next one up. Plenty of eager defence there from the Tigers. Moving in there very quickly was McKenna Gibson, read it very well, and he'll be made to play it just 13 out from his own line. Now it comes back across field. It's with Dan Wallace. Dan Wallace, a handful in the first half, but a little bit muffled in the second half. Played back to Fayud. He gets around the marker there of Kaufman. Steals about another 10 metres before the tackle's made, about 17 his own side of halfway. Now he plays it back to Tario. They put it through the hands. It goes out wide there through Seamark. Now it's with Greve. Greve runs out to the right, coming back towards centre field. He could still offload. He's holding it up with one hand. Now he gives it to Seamark. Held it up for an eternity. Now it's with Natush. Natush, he's still driving with the legs, looking to offload out the back. It's picked off there by the Tigers. So another error there for the Seagulls, and East will come up with the ball 9 metres inside Seagull's territory, and it was Ken Bromwich who's done. In fact, I'm not so sure he didn't call for the ball there, Troy. Zgrajewski takes the next one up, and he'll be stopped about 32 metres out from the Tigers' line. Played back there to Moylan. Moylan steals another 10 or 12 yards. Very slow to read the play there, Dane Carlaw, and Moylan will be made to play it. Now it's with McKenna Gibson. Comes across field to Kaufman. Kaufman, oh, he's got forwards running both sides there. Now it's with Walker. Walker will take the tackle just 13 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played it back to Newman. It goes back across the left there to Kaufman. Kaufman, dummy, still going himself. They've got an eternity of time here, Troy. There's absolutely no pressure being put on
the
East halves.
From the Seagulls.
He'll get up and play it back to McKenna Gibson, just 9 metres out from the line. Long 20-metre pass. A little grubber kick through there from Cody Walker, and it's been a mess. He's made a meal of it. We'll just see. It's been grounded by the Seagulls in goal, so this will probably be... I thought it might have been knock-on in the field of play. What's Clayton Sharp going to rule? He will. He'll bring it out for the knock-on, the initial knock-on. I thought he was saying it was grounded in goal. It was going to be a dropout, but it'll come back out for the scrum, and this will be a loose head and feed to the Tigers, just 10 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line, and it has not been a happy second half. 15 minutes into the second half, East leading Wynnum Manly, 24 points to 14, and looking all the winners at this stage. Scrum to pack, 10 metres out, Walker feeds. Now comes across field there to Kaufman. Kaufman looking to link up, he finds Newman. Newman can't get away from Fayud. Almost stands in the tackle. Eventually they wrestle him down with the help of Dalziel Don. 8 metres out, played back to Kaufman. Kaufman, dummies, goes himself at the line. They'll turn him around. Dalziel Don read it. They push him back to 4 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. East on the attack. He'll play it back to Tongia. He goes back to the left across field to McKenna Gibson. Comes back to McLean. McLean, he's a hard unit to stop. Goes back to the right. Eventually decides that he'll take the tackle. And quite... relaxed at the moment, the East attack. Played back there to Bromwich. Now they goes through the hands. It's with Mechanic Gibson. Now it's popped out the back to Thorpe. Thorpe, he'll end up taking the tackle just 10 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. What will we see from the Tigers? Gibson. Now it's with Walker. Dummy still going. Still going. Now he offloads out there to the centre. It looks like the ball's come loose. No, he's held onto it. Peter Gubb's calling for a loose ball. It is a lost ball. Well, wasn't sure what he was calling for a second there, Troy, but they've gotten out of the fire there, Wynnum Manly. Loxley takes a quick tap, and he'll steal about 7 metres straight up the centre of the field. In fact, he'll make it to the 30-metre line, so he's a good start to this set. He'll play it back to Torrio. They go out to the right. Dane Carlaw turns the left shoulder in, but the defence there from the Tigers is equal to the task, and Panapa's in over the top to wrap him up. We've got an East player down injured from that tackle. It's with Tim the Tush. And he's lost it. He has lost it. And don't know what John Torrio was asking of the ref, but it's play on. Moylan, he finds Kaufman, who's almost through the gap there. He's snatched there by Wallace, and Wallace will ride him to the ground. 30 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line, played back to Moylan. They go left again. It's with Bromwich. Bromwich straightens up, and he'll take three Wynnum Manly defenders with him, and eventually he'll be stopped 20 out from the line in centre field. Played back there to Holcomb. Holcomb, it's with Mechanic Gibson. Dummies, goes himself, takes it up 11 metres out from the line. The tackle that had to be made there by John Torrio. Played it back now. Holcomb doing all the dummy half work. It's with that's with Zgrajewski. Zgrajewski turns the shoulder in rather not really that committedly, and eventually takes the tackle. Now it's with Bromwich. It was almost slipping out the bottom. Bromwich holds onto it. He's only 2 metres out from the line. East on the attack. Holcomb into dummy half. He's got players calling for it both sides. He elects to go the open side. It's with Kaufman. There's the grubber kick in. Chased there by Walker. And going back for it is Matt Seamark. The whistle's gone for a penalty, and it's a Wynnum Manly penalty. What's that for there, Troy? Just in front of the kicker. And it's probably against Cody Walker, who's chased Matt Seamark all the way, but I don't think he'd be too concerned about it. Wynnum Manly will come up with the penalty just 10 metres out from their own line.
Wow, look, we're just seeing a relentless attacking blitzkrieg from the East Tigers, and no semblance of a capacity for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls to recover from this situation at this point. We're seeing Dan Wallace taking the ball into the teeth of the East Tigers defence, but some very tired, lethargic-looking Wynnum Manly Seagulls forwards. I know Dane Carlaw is trying to raise their spirits, but I'd be making some astute substitutions from the bench at the moment, Mike, if I was Paul Green.
Nat Barnes playing it on the second, right on halfway, back to Torrio. He'll take 10 metres, 12 metres, straight up the middle. No markers there whatsoever from the Tigers. Could have actually been penalised. Played back to Fayoud. He now gives it away to Carlaw. It's with Natosh. Natosh, good boy, and a Gubb! He's into the clear, Gubb! He breaks the first tackle. Now he gets it away to Seamark. Seamark gets it away to Peter Gubb, who'll go in for a terrific try for the Seagulls. They hit back. They've gone 70 metres there, Troy, completely against the run of play, and finishes with Peter Gubb scoring the try about 10 metres in from the car park sideline here at Langlands Park. Wynnum Manly back into this match. It's East 24, Wynnum 18 with a kick to come.
Well, it was a wonderful piece of anticipation from Dane Carlaw, because he called that from the open
side. Who'd have thought? So, unbelievable.
He got a quick, crisp pass to Tim Natush, who needed a moment of redemption, because he had caused this siege in the Wynnum Manly quarter here with two ill-conceived offloads. And he ran to the line and timed his run beautifully off the sleight of hand pass from Dane Carlaw, and then it was just a succession of quick passes which isolated the East defenders, and we've seen the Wynnum Manly player crash over in the corner for against the play 4-pointer, Mike, because as I say, just a siege situation down here at the southern end of the ground. They've just been camped in their half and repelling the repeated attacking raids from the East Tigers. But then it was just again a nice offload from Matty Seamark, who was the last pass to the ball supporter, who's crashed over and scored in the corner. So a much needed point of a difference for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls over what they've had to endure in the last 10 minutes.
Here's Seamark's conversion. Strikes it well from here. Touch, judges, flags go up. It's a kick that really needed to go over there too, Troy. But we've had 21 minutes of this second half, so we've only got 19 minutes of play remaining here at Langlands Park. And Eastern Suburbs are leading Wynnum Manly 24 points to 20. So East bringing it back for the kickoff. We've got still a quarter of this match to go, Troy. And look, a try like that against the run of play, anything can happen. This game is just amazing, start to finish.
It is, and it's going to be those defensive lapses which I think ultimately will decide who was the victor here this afternoon, Mike.
Fayoud brings the first one back after the kickoff. He'll eventually be stopped 30 out from his own line. Played it back there to Wallace. Wallace, oh, to Dalziel Don, who's hammered. Met there, golden black. Meeting reception there for him. Plays it back to Wallace. Now it comes across to Natush. Straight and hard. Bounces off the first one. They hold on to him. And Holcomb held on to him only just. He'll get up and play at 10 his own side of halfway. And a mistake in the play the ball. He's lost it there in the play the ball. So East will come up with the loose head and feed. 10 inside Wynnum Manly territory. And it's a mistake that they desperately did not hit, did not need after just getting back into this match.
Well, we've just missed the replay. To see who the culprit was there.
Tim
Natush has made his third consecutive handling error for the Seagulls in the last 15 minutes.
Well,
I don't know what the issues are with Tim and his handling, but he's costing precious field position for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls. And again, they're just having to repel these repeated attacking raids from the Tigers.
Kaufman takes the ball out the base of the scrum, gives it to Moylan. Willing defence there from the Seagulls. They make no ground on the first tackle there. They're the Tigers. Played it back to Kaufman. Now gets the ball away there to... Just trying to pick who that player was. I don't think it was McLean who took that one up. No. Anyway, they're still in possession, Gravesky. And... he'll be made to play the ball just 23 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played it back now. It's with Kaufman. Now he gets it out there to Bromwich. Bromwich gets it away to Newman. Newman takes the tackle. I don't think Newman was actually expecting it there, Troy. But he's had to take the tackle anyway. We've just got Fayoud grabbing at his right knee. Just keep an eye on him at the play the ball there, Troy. As East, they put it through the hands. Oh, hard running there from Panapa. He's really stepping up to the plate in this second half, and he'll be stopped just 6 metres out from the line. He'll play it back to Holcomb. Holcomb goes the short side. No, now he grubbers. It goes back infield. It's taken there by Loxley, pushing to try to get out of his own in-goal. Doesn't do so. It'll be another dropout for the Seagulls from underneath their post. He got down low to drive there, and the first player in there was Shane Moylan to slow him down. Two other defenders, there was no way to get out.
Well, again, just a very wonderful build-up from the East Tigers and utilising that just that wrecking ball that we're seeing in Leon Panapa in the second half. He's just finding, with nonchalant ease, some gaping holes on the fringes there, Mike, and it was only just good management from the Seagulls that they're able to again... prevent another four-point opportunity for the East Tigers.
Not a good dropout, but it's taken there well there by Tautali. They gained about another 10 metres on the bounce. Still going Tautali, running across field, but gets away from four or five defenders. Eventually, he'll be stopped 31 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Holcomb. He goes left. It's with Panapa again. Straight and hard, has his legs cut out from underneath him there by Matt Seamark. Coming in over the top was Dane Carlaw. Played back to Holcomb. Now it's with Walker. Walker, dummies. Dummies twice. Now it's with Kaufman. Cuts out Bromwich. Now it's with Corey Thompson into the open, going for the line. He'll score a try for the Tigers. What a great try. Sleight of hand there. Walker had the ball. There was a little bit of dummy. It just put the Wynnum Manly defence into two minds. There was no committed tacklers there to break it back. And then once Corey Thompson got it, he knew where the chalk was. Easter in again. They now lead by 28 points to 20. We've got 15 minutes of play remaining, and the Tigers have still got a conversion to come.
Well, Mike... Again, I'm going to have to question the peripheral vision of Clayton Sharp, because there was a blatant obstruction on Jacob Fayoud in that motion. However, again, culpability by the Wynnum Manly Seagulls defensive line because of just their lack of urgency. Luke Lauziel-Don is laying this point down in no uncertain terms in the in-goal area at this point. They are just not moving forward with any kind of commitment, and it just made it just so easy for Cody Walker. He committed two defenders, got that flick pass out to Isaac Kaufman, and then it was McKenna Gibson that doubled around and created that beautiful motion where he's just, oh, it's actually Corey Thompson, I beg your pardon, and then lost his footing, but with the momentum he had, he was able to stretch out and score a great try. But again, Isaac Kaufman just wreaking havoc out on the fringes here, because there's just that lethargy in the way that the Seagulls are moving forward. And it's going to be terminal here this afternoon if they don't rectify this immediately, Mike.
Oh, great kick there from Cody Walker, but it just hooks off to the right at the end. That's his first miss for the afternoon. But East leading Wynnum Manly 28 points to 20, 14 minutes to go. So it's game on here at Langlands Park. And this is your BayFM call team.
Mike, in the replay here, just for the sake of the listeners, you'll see that Jacob Fayud was obstructed by runner.
There was an interference, but referee was right there. He asked the question, but nothing coming of it. The try's been awarded. There's Seamark's kickoff. Going long again, straight down towards that Canbar corner. It's taken there well by Walker. And East will be quite content to run this ball out and just go right back to the basics there, Troy. It's Kenny Bromwich brings the first one out. He'll be stopped 15 metres out from his own line. Score through from Ipswich. And tight game out there too, Troy. It's 10-all between the Jets and the Tweed Seagulls. And they've got 20 minutes of play remaining. Played back to Holcomb. Now it's with... looks like it's with McLean. I think he's upended there. And great Jake Granville's in there with the help of Dane Carlaw to do it. Now played back there to Holcomb. It's with Zgrajewski. Oh, slides over in the tackle. And Carlaw comes in over the top. I thought there was a little bit of a hint of an arm above the shoulder there. But nothing comes of it again. Holcomb takes the next one up. And he'll be stopped 10 his own side of halfway. Played back to Gibson, who's back on the field. There's Walker's kick downfield. Tries to kick down towards that... clubhouse corner there, but gets caught in the breeze, and it's taken there by Loxley, who's met with some willing golden black defence. He'll be pushed back, and he'll be tackled about 26 metres out from his line. Played back to Barnes. Now it's with Peter Gubb, straight and hard, and he pushes Holcomb back about 5 metres after initial contact. Granville from dummy half throws a ball to Mr. Nobody, picked up there by Carlaw. Carlaw still going. Carlaw makes it up to just on halfway, finishes up a good run in the end. He makes about 15 metres, driving the East defenders back. Played back to Moon. Moon spots a half gap there, goes himself, pops it out the back, makes 10 metres. Now it's with Granville, accelerates. Granville had Big Tim the Tush on his left, but elected not to give it to him, and Granville will be tackled just 20 metres out from the east line. Terrible pass there to Seamark, takes it diving. Fayu, Dalziel Don, he's got Wallace with him. Now he gives it to Wallace, can't get away from the defence. It was well read there by Newman, very experienced player there, Newman, and he knows how dangerous Wallace was in the first half. The ball comes loose and he's calling it a lost ball. Well, there was plenty of interference before then, but some responsibility has to fall back on Dan Wallace.
The onus has to be on the ball carrier. Absolutely. To secure possession, Mike. It's as simple as that in rugby league.
Some of these mistakes are going to be fatal for the Seagulls. They need to clean these up now if they're in fact going to get back into this match. The East Tigers leading Wynnum Manly 28-20. We've only got 11 minutes of play remaining. This scrum to pack 20 metres out from the Tigers' line, and it will be an East loose head and feet.
It just seems to be a disintegration of the continuity in attack and a semblance of a relationship between the ball carrier and the ball runner, Mike. We just saw a complete breakdown in communication from the dummy half to Matt Seamark, who had to scramble to take that pass, and then ultimately we've seen a turnover from, agitation from the play-the-ball area. But again, onus is on the ball carrier to secure possession.
East in possession. They're only 22 metres out from their line and quite content to just use their forwards to... batter the Wynnum Manly forward pack, who has worked tirelessly this afternoon there, Troy, but you'd have to give kudos where it's worked, where it's been earned, and I would say that East marginally have had the better forwards performance this afternoon as Zgrajewski makes some good metres again, takes it up to just inside Wynnum Manly territory. Played it back now to Holcomb. Holcomb looks off to the right, elects to go himself, takes an easy 10 metres. Very lax marker defence again there from the Seagulls. Now it's with Cody Walker. Hoists the bomb, dropping back for it as Loxley. It was an awkward take. Eventually he'll take the tackle. Moylan chased it through, rode him into the ground. Eventually he'll be made to play it just 20 metres out from his own line. Played back to Barnes. Now it's with Gubb. Gubb, he'll only take about 5 metres as his legs cut out underneath him there by Moylan. Riding him in over the top was Thorpe. Now it's with Matt Smith back on the field, and he'll bring it up to about 7 metres his own side of halfway. Oh, marker defence well puts the pressure on Granville, and he loses it. The Tigers come up with the ball yet again.
Panic situation, Mike. Just a panic pass from Jake Granville, showing no... intelligence or composure under pressure.
Panapa is holding off the Wynnum Manly defence, and eventually he'll be made to play it, and there's the penalty. And
compounded by a penalty, Mike.
Absolutely. I tell you what, someone said something. Oh, Luke Dalziel Don's gone up to speak to Clayton Sharp. There was certainly a strip there. There's no point really arguing with it now unless it's just a ploy to give his players just a bit more of a rest there, Troy. But the penalty has been given, and East... don't know if they'll bother kicking for touch. They're only 23 metres out from the Wynnum-Manly line, and the Wynnum-Manly defence starting to wilt. There's the tap now. Now it's with, is that Panapa again? Takes the first one up, and he'll be stopped about 15 metres out from the Wynnum-Manly line. He'll play it back to Holcomb. Holcomb cuts out Graevsky. It's with Thorpe now. Thorpe met solidly there by Granville down low. Torrio comes in to help put him down. Eventually he'll play it 11 metres out from the Wynnum-Manly line. Holcomb goes the short side. Graevsky, oh, solid hit there from the Wynnum-Manly Seagulls. That's the first one. That's Dane Carlaw. It's the first one of the afternoon from the Seagulls. Holcomb goes out the back. Set play. Now it's with Bromwich. Holcomb's taken out in back play. Now it's with Corey Thompson, the try scorer. He comes up, pops it out the back to Bromwich. Bromwich looking to offload again. Plays it safe and he'll hold onto the ball. Plenty of defence in there from Wynnum-Manly, but Easter only 8 metres out from the line. Holcomb goes left. They put it through the hands. It's with Kaufman. Now it's with Walker. Straightens it up. And slowing him down is Seamark, and with the help of Dane Carlaw, they put him down just 10 metres out from the line. He'll get up and play it back to Holcomb. They go the short side. Panapa puts the grubber kick through. Chasing it through was Ryan Tongia. It's been grounded. Bit of push and shove at the back there with Shay Moylan and Loxley by the looks of it. Nothing coming of it. The whistle's gone there. Troy, was it actually a penalty?
No,
it is a penalty.
That was just a compensatory penalty to square the ledger for the statistics on the referee this afternoon. He was not in front of the kicker.
Kick for touch. Taken there by Granville. Now it's with Carlaw. This is where the big Wynnum-Manly forwards need to fire up. They've only got 8 minutes to go. Wynnum-Manly need to score twice if they're going to win this game. Comes back across field. It's with Natush. Natush straight and hard, met fairly solidly there by Ratana. And coming in down low there was Thorpe. And they put him down 2 metres inside his own territory. It's with Granville. Now it's with Fayud to Dalziel Don. Nowhere to go. Pops it out the back there to Loxley. Loxley tried to accelerate towards centre field, but he's ridden into the ground there by the East skipper Newman. Played back to Granville. Now it's with Fayud. Dummies back inside. Goes himself. Takes about 10 metres. That's four tackles down for the Seagulls. It's with Granville. Finds a little bit of space. Had Wallace on his left. Holds it himself. They're only 21 metres out from the east line. Now it's with Fayud. There goes the high bomb going across field. Going up for it will be Moylan. Takes it magnificently for the Tigers. And he'll save the day for East. He'll be pushed back in this tackle, though, fairly ruggedly there. It looks like it's Dalziel Don. And whistle's gone again there, Troy. Well, we've got a Wynnum-Manly player down where that ball came down. Just see what's going on
Matty
there.
Seamark,
I was going to say it might be number 7.
Struck by Shay Moylan's knee as he went to contest the ball. But we've just, as I said, Mike, we've seen just a complete disintegration of the continuity and fluidity of attack from
of the
Wynnum-Manly Seagulls.
Half.
Yes, it's just quite, I don't have an answer for it. Whether the rep players have just started to wilt under the relentless pressure from the East Tigers, because they have just been marshalled very intelligently and astutely by the halves combination of Cody Walker and Isaac Kaufman, just with that second phase and the decoy runners wrapping around from one side of the ruck to the open side or to the short side and picking up a runner at pace. And they've had to absorb a lot of defensive surety to repel those incisive raids. And it's just been a wonderful exhibition from both Kaufman and Cody Walker in the second half, which has given them this 28-20 lead over the Wynnum-Manly Seagulls.
Well, East in possession. They're 22 metres out from their own line and doing it fairly comfortably at the moment. Holcomb just offloads out the back to the left there. They've almost slowed the game here, East, haven't they, Troy? They've just got this game under control, and Cody Walker throws a good ball across field, as I just say that.
It's about to ignite and live now,
break
Mike.
There by Ryan Tongia. But they're just controlling this game at the moment, East, and Wynnum-Manly are finding it hard to just get a foothold back into launch any sort of concerted attack. Now, here's the kick downfield from Walker. He'll kick it down towards the clubhouse corner. It goes in goal. Going back for it there is Loxley. He'll get it back out into the field of play away from the first attempted tackle. He'll be stopped about 3 metres out from his own line. Played back to Barnes. Barnes finds hard-running Peter Gubb. Peter Gubb will take it out to 10 out from his own line, midway between the uprights and the car park side at Langlands. Now it goes back across field to Matt Smith. Matt Smith driving with his bulk and his legs, steals about 11 metres, and he'll get up and play at about 21 out from his own line. Dalziel Don looking to link up, and he's through. Dalziel Don throws a half dummy, looking to offload inside. It's with Fayoud. It will Fayoud get it? He does. It's with Wallace. Wallace setting sail into the open, and they won't get him. He'll go through and score 50 metres underneath the post.
Captain's knock, Mike.
Brilliant try by the Wynnum Manly Seagulls, and all set up by a break by their skipper, the man of the moment, Luke Dalziel Don, back inside his own half. Wynnum Manly are back into this match with 5 minutes to go. East 28, Wynnum 24 with a kick to come. And boy, oh boy, Troy, we're in for a grandstand finish.
Wow, Corey Thompson and Jordan McLean just could not compete with Luke Dalziel Don once he got into the open. His natural stride and his ability to shed tackles, but get the pass away in an impossible situation there with two defenders just enveloping his body. He was able to pick up Fayoud, and then Dan Wallace again just shows why he is the best centre in the Queensland Cup on form at this point of the season, and just powered away to score under the post to just give the Wynnum Manly Seagulls a semblance of stealing a victory here after just being on the back foot for the majority of this second half. But just to the replay here from the streaming from the East Tigers, Tiger TV shows Wallace crashing over after backing up that pass from Fayoud. But Luke Dalziel Don, just a poignant moment in this second half, taking it upon himself to run the ball on the short side, as he always does, just seems to find that ability to break a tackle, run a hole, and then pick up ball runners and supporters. And now we've seen Wallace crash over and score a great try for the Seagulls, 28-26.
Boy, oh boy, Troy, the crowd is on their feet. There is not a person who has left this ground. East leading 28-26, 4.5 minutes of play here at Langlands Park. And look, two of the best sides in the competition running around out here, Troy. And if there'll be something horrendously wrong if they don't both figure heavily once the finals come around. Eventually, the kickoff will be taken. It's a high kickoff going straight down to Jacob Fayoud. He's got Matt Smith on his right. Now he gives it. Smith goes straight and hard, straight into the teeth of the Tigers. And he'll bring it up out of the danger zone, 26 metres out from the Wynnum Manly line. Played back to Fayoud. Now it's with John Torrio. Steps off the left, slings around. Now it's in the hands of Granville. Wynnum Manly know they've got to score again yet. It's with Matt Smith, and eventually he'll take the tackle about 36 metres out from his own line. Granville goes from dummy half, and he'll take 15 metres and plenty of stopping, and he'll be tackled about 3 metres inside East Territory. Played back to Fayoud. Can Wynnum Manly get out of jail here? It's with Seamark. Now it's with Carlaw. Carlaw into a half break, looking to offload, eventually takes the tackle. They're only about 18 metres out from the East line. What will we see? It's with Seamark. He's got Granville with him. Now he gives it. Holds it off, giving it to Matt Smith, and eventually the tackle will be made. They're running out of time here, the Seagulls. This is the fifth tackle. What will we see? It's played back to Torrio. Now it's with Seamark. There's a little chip over the top. The chase is good for Moon. It's knocked back, picked up there by Carlaw. He'll score the try. Wynnum Manly have scored the try. They hit the front. 3 minutes of play remaining. Two tries in 2 minutes. Are we looking at a miracle? The try's been given. Dane Carlaw. Wynnum Manly hit the front. 30-28 with a kick to come. 3 minutes to go. Troy,
well,
what can you say?
What can I say? Jake Granville, again, just that ability to find holes in a fatiguing, tiring defensive line, running from dummy half, committing defenders, and then linking up beautifully with his outside men here. From that run, it was number 14 that got into dummy half for the Wynnum Manly Seagulls. It was John Torrio. And then from that ensuing kick, we saw Dane Carlaw backing up after he'd made a 30-metre run. And it's a just reward for Dane Carlaw. I think I've made the decision already who will be man of the match, because in this second half, without Carlaw's contribution, Wynnum Manly wouldn't be in this winning position, Mike.
Well, Matt Seamark will come up and take the slowest conversion in history. Troy, I'm absolutely
convinced. What are the rules in the Queensland Cup? Can you take 2 minutes 20 to take a conversion, Mike?
Oh, look, seriously. He'll have this ball set. It's about 4.5, maybe 5
time
metres.
Time fades away here, Mike.
In from touch, and he's 22 metres out. Wynnum Manly have hit the front, 30 points to 28, and who would have thought 5 minutes ago? Unbelievable. Luke Dalziel Don trying to get his troops focused back on the job at hand, because play will restart after Seamark's conversion. It's almost an irrelevant point kicking this conversion, but we'll see what happens. It's struck pretty well there by Seamark from out wide. It's waved away. The conversion's unsuccessful. He hasn't had a good day with the boot, the halfback Matt Seamark, but Wynnum Manly have hit the front, 30 points to 28. We've got 94 seconds left on the clock. And East, well, they ran the ball back to halfway a little bit quicker than they did last time there, Troy. There's the kickoff. They're going the short kickoff down to Luke Dalziel. Don going up for the winger. He's knocked it back. It's picked up there by East. It's going to be play on. No, the referee's going to say knock on. Well, I tell you what, it looked like it was knocked back from here. We had the benefit of the 30-metre line. East aren't arguing, so I think they know it did go forward. They've rushed in to pack the scrum. Wynnemani will come up with the feed. Fayoud's got the ball. There's 68 seconds on the clock. Referee Clayton Sharp just having a little word there to Shane Newman, just telling him to walk away. So I don't know if something was said. He's telling Panapa to hurry up and pack into the scrum. But 68 seconds left on the clock. Wynnemani to feed, 38 from their own line. In by Fayoud. Comes out the back there with Luke Dalziel. Don shoves away Kaufman. Comes back at him a second time. They'll wrestle him to ground 12 metres inside his own half. So Wynnemani may have pulled off a miracle here. Played back to Fayoud. Now it's with Grieve, who's back on the field. Turns backwards into the defence. He'll be made to play at 8 metres his own side of halfway. Played back to Granville. Back to Natush now. Natush straight and hard. Takes it up to the chalk of halfway. And eventually, he'll play it. Played it back to Granville now. Now it's with Torrio. They just need to hold onto the ball here. Wynnemani. Torrio's through into the open, looking to offload. The defence swarms in on him. And eventually, he'll be stopped 19 metres out from the line. The Seagulls are circling. Will they come up with another try right on halftime? Right on full time. Played back to Granville. Now it's with Seamark. Dummy still going, Seamark. He holds the ball 10 metres out. The whistle goes again. And it's another penalty for offside against East. What will Seamark do? Just take a quick tap and go himself. Throws it straight out wide there to the wing. Peter Gubb going for the line. He'll score a try. Well, can you believe it? Peter Gubb, he's had a great game all day. He comes up with his second try right on full time for the Wynnemani Seagulls. Wynnemani are in again. It's 34-28 with a kick to come. And the 80 minutes has in fact ticked over. And I tell you, Troy McCarthy and his East players will be absolutely wondering what's happened in the last 6 minutes of this game.
I'll be shell-shocked, Mike. Well, how they squandered this position of ascendancy in the last 10 minutes. It's just been a complete momentum shift in this game.
Well, it's been Jekyll and Hyde. And this is what I pointed out in the first half. It seemed like both sides had the capability to put anything on anywhere on the field. And Wynnemani have just done it three times in the last... What's that? Three times in the last 5 minutes. It's not unlike that game we called on BayFM a few years ago where Wynnemani got over the top of the Burley Bears.
Yes, yes.
So Matt Seamark will step...
A couple of moments of individual brilliance from some key players, Mike, that have just given Wynnemani an unlikely victory here in the second half.
Well, I'm just looking to see who the goal kicker is this time. Is it John Torrio who's lining up this kick, Troy? It's over on the far side of the field. It certainly looks like Torrio from here. It's not Matt Seamark. It is Torrio. Well, he's got this ball set 3 metres from the sideline. And about 18, maybe 20 metres out. I tell you what, he struck it pretty well. It's waved away. That will be full time here at Langlands Park. Well, we've absolutely seen it all. Wynnemani have gotten out of the fire here. They have defeated East 34 points to 28 in one of the most remarkable matches I've seen, Troy. Certainly one of the most remarkable games we've seen calling on BayFM and for the Wynnemani Seagulls. But who would have thought, with 6 minutes of play remaining, I tell you what, Clayton Sharp just copped a spray from a couple of East supporters, I can hear. Who would have thought with 6 minutes to go, Troy, that Wynnemani would be walking away with the points? Well, certainly not myself.
Again, it was just that outstanding situation created by Luke Dalziel-Don, where he took it upon himself to just run at the line, crash through a couple of ineffectual tackles, and then just found that old Dalziel-Don razzle-dazzle and showed surprising speed over 40 metres and also physicality and strength to shed those two defenders and then set up Fayoud for the last pass to Dan Wallace, and it's just been the turning point in this second half. Virtually written off with say 10 minutes to go, but just that defining moment, and then also some incisive runs from Jake Granville has made the difference here this afternoon, Mike. I'll see if I can get a word with Dane Carlaw at the Wynnemani Leagues Club and BayFM Man of the Match.
Well, both sides milling around halfway as we speak. I know the Tigers do their player of the match awards on field this season. as some rather very smiling Wynnum Manly players leaving the field. I tell you what, I still don't think that Coach Paul Green will be too happy with the performance of some of the players during that second half period, because they certainly went flat there for a long period of time. The Wynnum Manly side, they were outplayed in the forward pack for about 20 minutes of that second half, and East, well, they had the game wrapped up at 24-14 and then 28-20, but they just couldn't go on with it. Wynnum Manly, three tries in the last 5 minutes to run out winners with this match, 34 points to 28, and Troy Robbins is just down grabbing our BayFM player of the match this afternoon, and we'll cross down to him now.
Yes, thank you, Mike. Our Wynnum Manly Leagues Club BayFM man of the match, probably one of his most telling performances in a Wynnum Manly jersey this season. Dane Carlaw, outstanding second half from you. Took it upon yourself when you were under siege in that second half from a rampant East Tigers to really inspire the boys to come back with some composure and ultimately secure victory this afternoon.
Well, that's a lot of words there, mate. Yeah, you know, we were under the pump there in that second half. You know, it was just a great effort from our guys. You know, it showed a lot of ticker and, you know, to put the little things right. And in those sort of big pressure games, that's what gets you home. So, you know, we sort of grounded out, and then the last 10, we come home with a wet sail. You know, got there in the end, which is, you know, a great effort leading into the finals, I think. So, yeah, it's time to play finals footy now, so we're starting to put that in place.
Dane, late in your career, you must be really enjoying the coaching of Paul Green, because he seems to be utilising you as a ball player as much as a battering ram in your tenure at the Wynnum Manly Seagulls, and it's working wonderfully as a second phase option for the side.
Yeah, mate, I enjoy getting out a little bit wider, you know, playing nice and tight in the early stages to get a bit of a touch and you know, get involved, and then in the back end of the games drift a bit wider, and you know, when there's a bit more space, so I enjoy doing that, and you know, hopefully I can keep doing it till the rest of the season, and you know, see how things go back to back, hopefully.
And, mate, just in terms of that try that you've just scored to seal victory this afternoon, can you remember statistically when it was the last time you crossed the white chalk for the Seagulls or your other incarnations in the Queensland Cup?
Mate, few and far between, mate, especially playing in the middle there. So, you know, it's always good to get out of the line. It's my first one for the year, so no need to run at the end of the year, which is good.
Look, Dane, congratulations on an outstanding performance this afternoon. You certainly made a massive difference in that second half to secure victory. So well done, man of the match from the Wynnum Manly Seagulls Leagues Club and BayFM man of the match. Well done.
Oh, thanks for that, mate. Yeah, enjoy me footy here. And yeah, thanks to all our supporters who come out today and, you know, listening today on the radio. So good on you. Thanks.
Thanks, Dane.
Dane Carlaw, Troy Robbins' pick as player of the match. Probably could have given it to a few players. No one really stood out as having a starring role for Wynnum Manly this afternoon. They certainly had their ups and downs. It was a bit of a Jekyll and Hyde performance there for a period of time in both halves. But Dane Carlaw certainly stepping up where it counts. And in the second half, he certainly got the Wynnum Manly forwards on the front foot. Of course, you probably could have given it to Luke Dalziel Don as well there, Troy, because he was a key man in that second half. He was down here rousing up the troops when East skipped out with those two quick tries, or three tries they scored. And certainly he was letting it be known that he was not happy with some of the mistakes that they were coming up with.
Look, yes, I identified two consecutive handling errors from Tim Natouche, which just had Wynnum Manly camped on their try line. And again, I thought it was just a very astute and intelligent use of their major attacking weapons and damaging runners from Isaac Kaufman and Cody Walker, with Leon Panapa virtually just unstoppable there for that 20-minute period leading up to the final 10 minutes, where he just continually terrorised a faltering and fatiguing Wynnum Manly defensive line. And again, he had some willing conspirators in Ken Bromwich and Matt Krasinski. And we have to remember too that the Tigers lost Steve Thorpe in that first half, which certainly negated their ability to utilise their interchange with that forward that was certainly contributing in the first half with his size and his imposing stature. He was a real handful for the Seagulls' defence. But again, as you mentioned, that finding moment of Luke Dalziel Don, just with the responsibility as captain, again, just taking it upon himself to impart some influence on the game, and what an influence it was at that moment, because we can't underestimate, for the people that are listening this afternoon, just how important that that scything run was down on the western side of the field. I mean, he ran virtually 50 metres and then carried two defenders, and one of them was Jordan McLean, who was, at my estimation, about 6'4", completely enveloping Luke, and then also I think it was Cody Thompson who was around the legs, but he still managed with his strength and his determination to get that beautiful and I suppose trademark Dalziel Don one-handed pass to Jacob Fayoud, who backed up intuitively, and then it was just a running Dan Wallace that was able to get up on his toes and show a great acceleration to evade the cover defenders and score under the post.
Well, while you get some of your abridged stats there together there, Troy, shot coming through from North Ipswich Reserves, and I tipped it on air on the BayFM Sports program this morning. The Ipswich Jets have got up to defeat Tweed Heads 24 points to 10. Comprehensive victory out there, and a fair bit of credibility there too, Troy, without a Donald Malone, who's been one of their most potent attacking weapons all season. So congratulations on the Jets. Of course, here at Langlands Park, Wynnum Manly have just gotten up to Dowse East Tigers, 34 points to 28. The under-16s match up at Toowoomba today, finished with the under-16 Maroons 46, far too good for New South Wales Country 16. It was a bit of a triathlon today. Certainly the spectators, big crowd here at Langlands Park, got their money's worth at 7-5. I'll run through the victors first. For Wynnum Manly, 2 tries to Nat Barnes in the 25th and 30th minute. Dan Wallace scored 2 tries in the 35th and 75th minute. And Peter Gubb scored 2 tries in the 60th and 80th minute. And of course, that second last try by Dane Carlaw, just simply sensational. That was the one that was the sealer for the Seagulls. Matt Seamark, not a happy day with the boot. He kicked 3 from 6. John Torrio, none from 1. Just taking that last conversion attempt. The 5 tries for the East Tigers this afternoon to Tautali in the 5th minute. Cody Walker in the 46th minute, Zgrajewski in the 40th minute, Panapa in the 51st minute, and Corey Thompson, spectacular try in the 65th minute. Walker also landed 4 goals from 5 attempts. That's 34 points to 28. The Wynnum Manly Seagulls have managed to get up over the East Tigers. Now, you've got some stats there from the match there, Troy.
Yes, sir. Get him, Matty. Just seeing Matty Williamson, the head trainer. Just a BayFM entourage being... swamped by Wynnum Manly supporters here, Mike, who are extremely relieved and joyous with the result this afternoon. But look, I've got the completions for the first half. The East Tigers 13 out of 16 and Wynnum Manly 16 out of 18. And I didn't record a handling error for the Tigers in that second half.
Not in the second half.
14 out of 14 from the Tigers. Again, they'll just be stunned with that statistical result. And the fact that they've walked away from this this match losers. But Wynnum Manly, 16 out of 20 completions, and there were those 4 critical handling errors. And 3 of those were...
3 went directly to tries.
Yeah, that's right. And Tim Natouche was
the culprit.
The culprit, and he had a co-conspirator there also with that that turnover when it was down in East Territory, which then just again released that pressure valve. But it was just that... that momentous 10-minute period between the 70 and 80th minute, which just completely transformed the Seagulls. As I said, they looked incoherent in the way that the breakdown in communication was just derailing their attacking prowess that we saw so seamlessly in the first half. And then it was just that, it was almost like Luke lighting that fuse and taking in the responsibility for the side's ability to resurrect a potential win from a losing situation, and then also again astute use of the interchange bench in those dying embers of that second half by the coach to get Jake Granville back out there.
Well, they were down by 28 points to 20 at that stage there, Troy. There's only 5 minutes left on the clock. You would have thought the Tigers could close it out there. They were controlling the rucks. They were slowing the play down to suit themselves. They were upping the intensity at times, just catching the Wynnum Manly defenders short. And then Luke Dalziel Don, it's like harking back to when he first came into grade football. And